Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Landscapes of Enderal, Farmer's Coast, which I found here in the meat market at the Ark Marketplace. Landscapes of Enderal, The Farmer's Coast, a guide by the Golden Sickle, for travelers and traders. A green and plentiful stretch of land extends from the Lake of Ark, with the great capital Ark itself, its harbor to the south, and the Farmer's Coast to the north. The Farmer's Coast consists of flat hills and a cliff rising to the east. The meadows here are painted in a rich green, and large amounts of grain are grown in the lower valleys. It comes as no surprise that a good part of the food consumed in Ark and its hinterland is harvested here, together with raw materials for the town market. You enter the Farmer's Coast upon leaving Ark through the northern gate and wandering through a forest. There, a path branches away, leading to the icy mountain pass around the ruin of old Uskusarak. It is advised against to go this way unless you happen to be well armed and prepared for the cold. If you wander straight ahead and cross the river at the bridge, you arrive at Bridgehead Farm, where family Hafner has settled down with a store. There you will also find the only tavern in the Farmer's Coast offering strong cider, the Red Ox. It is delicious and, within reasonable dimensions, quite digestible. By the way, the Red Ox did not receive its name by chance. In the inn, you will meet the ox in person. Following the path from Bridgehead Farm in the direction of northwest, you will arrive at the extensive fields near Corn Farm. Leaving the corn farm westbound, you enter the deep forests of the Heartlands, from where a different path leads to a beach that extends far to the east, following steep cliffs. Be wary when leaving the inhabited parts of the Farmer's Coast. It can get dangerous for unarmed travelers. The shoreline is long, and the cliffs hardly offer any paths leading upward. Arm yourself well before heading there, and prepare yourself for long marches. If you should decide to leave Bridgehead Farm eastwards, onto the rising cliffs, you will pass by all the other homesteads in the Farmer's Coast, including landlord Borek's farm, who is entrusted with leading the peasants. In case you feel a need to speak to Malthus, head to Pater Ekamaton near the landlord's farm. At the Farmer's Coast's northern end, there is a large cave commonly called the Glowstone Grotto. Beware of exploring it. Shortly before arriving at the grotto, however, you can visit the old farmer's throne, which is located on one of the upper farm's fields. Legend has it that the throne stood there before humans ever set foot in this region. It is customary among the farmers to swear the new landlord to his holy duties every few years. To adventurers, the Farmer's Coast might appear to be a calm and quiet place, although vatiers have been known to strike terror into people's hearts for quite some time. Malthus would thank you should you free a cellar or two from these beasts. Those who wander farther east can follow a narrow path, starting at the last settlement before the huge mountain ridge, the Upper Farm. You are able to find him behind the grain field above the river's ravine. Follow the steps up to the Autumn Pass, where a small fortress is located. It has not been manned for years, and you will encounter lawless rabble at best. The fortress is known as Ark's Last Watch, and guarded the pass in times long forgotten, ensuring safe passage during winter. But since no one travels to the Golden Forest anymore, it is in desolate condition. Passing by the fortress, you arrive in the Golden Forest Vale, where the ancestral castle of the Dalmarak lies. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, Landscapes of Enderal, Farmer's Coast.